Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-R,
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the TEAS. We have been solving math problems out of this book here, the ATI TEAS study manual, the 6th edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today is our lesson number 133. And we are on page number 81. We are doing the three practice problems at the bottom of page 81. Today we'll do problem number 3. But before I begin problem number 3, I want to fix a boo-boo that I made yesterday in the work on problem number 2, which was in the multiplication here. And you will find that 2 times 0 is 0, 2 times 5 is 10, 2 5s are 10, 0 carry 1, 8, 2, 8 is 16, plus 1 is 17, 7 carry 1, and oh, this is where the mistake happened. Carry 1. See? 2 times 8. 2 8s are 16 plus 1 is 17. 7. Carry 1. And 2 1s are 2 plus 1 is 3. This should have been 3. This should have been 3. Well, if that's 3, 3 plus 8 is 11. Let's continue what happens. And now we multiply by 1. So we carry the unit, we hold the unit digit and multiply by 1. It's just going to be 0581, 0581, 0581. Let's add them up. So we get 0, 0, 12, 2, carry 1. And now it's 11 plus 1 is 12. This is going to become 12. It's 222. It turns out that 18 and a half times 12 is 222, not 212. I made a mistake. And I'll tell you why I made a mistake. I made that mistake because as I was doing it, I had this gut feeling. I didn't like it. I hated it the way I was doing it. Because this is very nerdy, very geeky. It's not very intuitive. This is not how I would have done it had I been doing my work myself. Let me show you what I would have done, okay? 18 and a half times 12 is what we're trying to figure out. 18 and a half times 12. Do it on the blackboard here. Multiplying 18 and a half by 12 should not have to turn into a freak show. Look, 18 and a half. 18.5 times 12. That's what we are trying to figure out. But don't write it like this. Write it like this. 18 and a half. 18 and a half times 12. That's what we are trying to figure out. 18 and a half times 12. And it's very simple. It's very simple. I'm going to write the other way so we can see it easily. So we're trying to figure out 12 times 18 and a half. Watch what happens. Watch what happens. First, figure out what 12 times 18 is. Do it on the side here. 12 times 18. 12 times 18. 8 2s are 16. 6 carry 1. 8 plus 1 is 9. That part is done. Times 1 is just going to be 2 and 1. 6, 1 is 11, 1 and 2. So that's your 18 times 12. We have taken care of it. 18 times. We have taken the 12 18. 12 18s are 216. Now, 12 halves. How much are 12 halves? 12 halves is the same as saying half of 12. 12 halves is 6. 12 halves are 6. 12 halves are 6. So that this quantity represents 12, 18. And this quantity right here represents 12 halves. And now we would not have gone wrong. 6 plus 6 is 12. 2 carry 1 and 222. And then he had $25 to begin with because his brother had given him $25 and he'll end up having $247. He needed only how much did he need to buy his concert ticket? He needed $235. He wanted to save at least $235. It turns out that if he saves for 12 weeks, at the end of the 12th week, he'll end up having plenty of money. He wanted $235. At least you'll end up having $247 if he saves $18.50 every week. But that's not the way of doing it, you understand?
Let's do problem number 3. Problem number 3, of 3, today is day number 133. It says Mary has only $20 for a cab ride. She wants to take a taxi, but she only has $20 bill in her wallet. She knows that taxi charges $2.75 to start with.
As soon as you get in the cab, this means with. This means without. As soon as she gets in the cab, as soon as it turns the meter on, it begins with $2.75. That's the starting point in the cab.
Then, you know, she knows that after that, then the taxi is going to charge $1.25 for each mile that she rides. Question is very straightforward. What is the farthest she can go?
What's the farthest she can go? Let's see how the books phrases the question. It says, Mary wants to take a taxi to a restaurant. She has $20 for the taxi ride, plus some change in her purse for the driver's tip. Aren't they nice? I mean, they're telling you that she's not a cheapskate. She's going to give some tip as well. The taxi company charges $2.75 to go in, to get in the cab, plus $2.25 per mile. If M represents the miles that she's going to ride to the restaurant, which of the following expression represents the maximum distance to a restaurant that Mary can afford? We rephrase that as, what's the farthest she can go? Notice the language. What is the
farthest? I'm digressing big time because it's a common mistake I hear.
What's the farthest she can go? Not furthest.
That is wrong.
Okay.
We say this thing is far.
My house from the school is far from here. Why don't we go to Michael's house? If your house is far from here, why don't we go to Michael's house to have dinner? Are you kidding me? Michael's house is even farther.
Is even
farther, not further.
Michael's house is even
farther. Far, farther.
People have a mistake. People have a nasty habit of saying his house is
farther. It's not further, it's farther. His house is even farther. But then why don't we go to Bob's house then? Are you kidding me? Bob's house is the farthest one from here. His house is the farthest one. Far, farther, farthest, not further. Further means additional. The meaning of the word further is additional, which is why we say, do you have anything further to say? No further comments. Nothing further to say, Your Honor. In the courtroom drama, you will see no further questions, no further comments. Further means additional. Don't confuse the word further with farther. They are two different words with two very different meanings. Far, farther, and farthest. And farthest, of course, is the superlative. I don't know why we're getting in such digression. Superlative, comparative, far, farther, farthest. What's the farthest that she can go in the cab if she only has $20? Let's find out, shall we? Enough of the talk.
Well, if she rides only 1 mile, we know 1 mile of ride. 1 mile of ride will cost.
How much will 1 mile of ride? 1 mile of ride will cost.
Well, you have to pay $2.75 just to get in the cab. And then, if you're going to ride 1 mile, they're going to charge you $1.25
for each mile. It's $1.25.
At the end of 2 miles, how much will a ride of 2 miles cost?
If you ride 2 miles, how much would that cost?
A 2 mile ride will cost $2.75 that you have to pay just to get in the cab, and then $1.25 for the first mile,
and $1.25 for the second mile,
which is same as saying $1.25 times 2. In which case, here we could have written as $1.25 times 1. So this 1 and 2 that you see there, that represents the number of miles, which we are told in the book to use letter M to represent it, which makes sense. at the end of third mile, a three mile ride will end up costing $2.75 just to get your derriere in there, and another $1.25 times 3.
I find it very peculiar for the English language that it is not considered proper and polite and civilized to use the English word in the way I just did it. It would have been considered vulgar, but if for some reason it's considered perfectly acceptable to say derriere. But I could have said the other word. That would have sounded very vulgar. So it will cost $2.75 plus $1.25 times 3 to go 3 miles. As I said, $2.75 itself, just you have to pay just to get your derriere in there. That's it. As soon as you get in, that's $2.75. The question is, how far can she go? Well, how far can she go? That's our unknown. Let's use letter M to represent the number of miles. If you use M to represent the number of miles that she's going to travel, then M miles will cost $2.75 to begin with, plus $1.25 times M. There you go, that's the right expression. That's the expression we were looking for. And we are told that this total amount of money that she will spend has to be no more than $20, because $20 is all she has got. She cannot go over it. Let's express that idea in the form of an inequality on the top. The topics are just three parts to it. Expressions, equations, and inequalities. We have the right expression. That's the right expression.
$2.75 plus $1.25 times the number of miles that you're going to travel, which we do not know. And this quantity that you see has to be less than or equal to $20.
If it's exactly equal to $20, that's fine. She can afford $20. She has $20 bill in her hand. And if the driver asks for exactly $20, she can manage that.
So it can be exactly equal to $20, or it can be less than that. But it cannot be more than that. It has to be less than or equal to $20.
That's it. As far as the book is concerned, as far as the exam is concerned, that's all they're looking for. They want you to come up with the right expression, or rather the right inequality, to express the notion, the concept that was described in the problem, which is she has $20, that's all she can spend on a cab ride, given the fact that cab costs $2.75 just to get in, and another $1.25 for each mile that you travel, what's the farthest that I can go if I only have $20? This is how you'll express that. All of that thing that we just said here is expressed so elegantly, so eloquently, so succinctly in the language of algebra. Algebra is very powerful. Everything that we just said is this right here. Let's solve for the number of miles. Even though the book does not ask for it, even though the book does not require it, we're going to solve for it just for the hell of it, just for learning purposes. Let's do it together. Let's solve for M. We're going to solve for this unknown, because I'm curious, how many miles can I travel with the $20 in my wallet? Well, first thing we need to do is get rid of this 275, which is a positive 275. Let's subtract 275 from both sides. Now you'll see that we have a positive 275 and a negative 275. They're going to cancel each other. So we end up with 1.25m, which has to be less than or equal to 20 minus 275. How much is 20 minus 275? Well, don't make a freak show out of it, you understand? Do not make a freak show out of it. We know 20 minus 3. How much is 20 minus 3? 20 minus 3 is 17. 20 minus 3 is 17. But we're not subtracting $3. We're only subtracting $2.75. So we got to give a quarter back. There we go. Let's multiply both sides of the inequality by 100. Let's multiply both sides of the inequality by 100 so we can get rid of these decimals. So now we end up with 100 times 1.25, which is 125m, which has to be less than 1725 times 100 is going to be 1725. Let's divide both sides by 125. And if you want to pick up the calculator and just do it out, divide 70.25 by 1.25, which is perfectly fine. I don't expect you to do this, all of this thing that I'm doing right now on the blackboard yourself. As I said, this is just for learning purposes, not for the exam. So we have 125 on the top, 125 on the bottom. It cancels out, and it tells us that the number of miles that we can travel has to be less than or equal to this quantity right here. Let's divide top and bottom by 25. What are we going to do? Divide by 25. Or if you like, we can divide by 5 and then divide by 5 again. We'll do it both ways. Let's first do the baby-ish way. Let's do the baby step first. We're going to divide top and bottom by 5 the first time. And then you will see that we can divide top and bottom by 5 one more time. Because this is a multiple of 25. This is a multiple of 25. Let's divide top and bottom by 5 first, shall we? So, how many fives does 17 have? 17. Well, let's begin the story properly. Let's begin the story properly so that we don't get confused. Okay. How many 5 does 1 have? How many 5 does 1 have? 1 has no 5s. 1 has no 5s. 1 is too puny to have any 5s. But what happens to that 1? That 1 goes and joins the 7 and becomes 17. And 17 has 3 5s. 3 5s are 15. After we take away 15 from the 17, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins this 2 and becomes a 22. And 22 has 4 5s. 4 5s are 20. After we take away 20 from the 22, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins this 5 and becomes a 25. And 25 has 5 5s. Now, if you had trouble understanding this thing, what I just did here, watch this series of basic math and learn how to divide quickly. Since we divide the top by 5, we must divide the bottom by 5. And if you like, very quickly, we can do the same process here on the side, so you see what you so you understand what we're doing here. We're done with all the work. I'm going to erase all of this thing. We can erase all of this thing. This is what we're doing here. We just divided 1725 by 5, and I'm going to show you what went on. 1725 by 5 is what we did. Okay, watch what happens. I'm going to do it one more time. How many 5 does 1 have? How many 5 does 1 have? 1 has no 5. 1 is too puny to have any 5. It has no 5. But then what happens to that 1? That 1 joins the 7 and becomes a 17. That 1 joins the 7 and becomes a 17. How many 5 does 17 have? 17 has 3 5s. 17 has 3 5s. 3 5s are 15. I'm going to erase this thing now so we don't get confused. 17 has 3 5s. After we take 3 5s are 15. After we take away 15 from the 17, after we take away 15 from the 17, we have a remainder of 2. What happens to that 2? Well, that 2 goes and joins this 2. That remainder of 2 goes and joins this 2 and becomes a 22. And 22 has 4 5s. 22 has 4 5s. 4 5s are 20. After we take away 20 from the 22, we have a remainder of 2. What happens to that 2? Well, that 2 goes and joins this 5. That 2 goes, the remainder of 2 from here, remainder of 2 from here goes and joins this 5 and becomes a 25. We can't do this here. It is not this 2 that joins the 5. It's the remainder of 2. It's not this 2 that's joining the 5. It's the remainder of the 2, which is why we can't do curly thing underneath it. Do you understand? So 22 has 4, 5. 4, 5 is a 20. After we take away 20 from the 22, we have a remainder of 2. After we take away 20 from the 22, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins the 5 and becomes a 25. And 25 has 5 5s. Voila. Since we divided top by 5, we must divide the bottom by 5. Let's divide the bottom by 5. Let's divide the bottom by 5. How many 5 does 1 have? Well, 1 has no 5. How many 5 does 1 have? 1 has no 5. What happens to that 1? That 1 goes and joins the 2, becomes a 12. And 12 has 2 5s. 12 has 2 5s. After which, 2 5s are 10. After we take away 10 from the 12, we have a remainder of 2. What happens to that 2? After we take away 10 from the 12, we have a remainder of 2. What happens to that 2? That 2 is going to go and joins the 5 and becomes a 25. It joins the 5 and becomes a 25, and 25 has 5 5s. Let's divide top and bottom by 5 one more time. Let's divide top and bottom by 5 one more time. So now we are dividing 345 by 5 and 25 by 5. 345. How many 5 does 3 have?
3 has no 5s. That 3 goes and joins the 4, becomes 34. 34 has 6 5s. 6 5s are 30.
After we take away 30 from the 34, we have a remainder of 4. What happens to that 4? That 4 is going to go and join the 5 and becomes a 45.
And 45 has
9 5s. 9 5s are 45. Since we divided the top by 5, we must divide the bottom by 5.
25 divided by 5 is 5.
So the bottom line is,
it is the m that we're looking for.
The m that we're looking for has to be
less than or equal to this quantity. M that we're looking for has to be less than or equal to 69 over 5.
69 over 5. You could divide 69 over 5.
I'm going to make it simple. Let's multiply top and bottom by 2.
60 times 2 is 120, and 9 times 2 is 18. 120 plus 18. 120 plus 20 would have been 140, so it's going to be
138. 138 over 10.
Are you still with me? Why did we multiply top and bottom by 2? Because it's very easy to divide by 10 than it is to divide by 5.
So it turns out that the m, the number of miles that she's going to travel, the number of miles that she's going to travel has to be less than or equal to 138 divided by 10, which is 13.8. She must make sure that she does not go over 13.8 miles.
But since the cab charges strictly by the mile, they don't do 0.8 miles, she will have to get out of the taxi at the end of the 13th mile. At the end of the 13th mile, she'll have to jump out of the cab, because otherwise she will not have enough money. She only has $20. She only has $20. She cannot ride.
She cannot ride 14 miles or more. If she does, she'll be in trouble.
If she does, she'll be in trouble. Let's see how much it costs to ride 13 miles, shall we?
Let's find out. How much does it cost to ride 13 miles? What should I erase? I need to erase something. How much is it going to cost her to ride 13 miles?
Well, we know.
We know that each mile costs $1.25. We want to find out
how much does it cost to go 13 miles.
Well, instead of writing it like this, I'm going to write that as 13 times 1 1/4.
Watch what happens.
13 times 1 1/4, because 1.25 is 1 1/4. Now it becomes very simple. 13 times 1 is 13, of course. And how much money do you suppose
you will have if you have 13 quarters? You see,
13 quarters. 13 times a quarter is 13 quarters.
Well, I know 4 quarters are 1. 4 quarters make $1. 4 quarters are 1. I also know 8 quarters are 2. And 12 quarters are 3.
12 quarters are 3. Therefore, 13 quarters, 13 times a quarter, must be $3.25. So that's 16.25. Plus the fact that when she gets in the cab,
she has to pay $2.75 just to get in the cab. You have to add that $2.75 as well.
And now you'll see that comes out to be exactly $19.
She doesn't have enough money to go another mile, because she only has a dollar left, and another mile will end up costing her $1.25. She doesn't have that another 25 cents. So the most that she can ride is 13 miles. At the end of 13 miles, she'll have to.
The conclusion is that at the end of 13 miles, she will have to jump out of the cab.
If she does not jump out of the cab at the end of 13 miles, she's in trouble, because she's going to be quarter short. But all of this work was not required. In the exam, they do not ask us to solve for m. They do not ask us to find out the value for m. They simply wanted us to come up with the right inequality, which we had done in the very beginning, which was very simple.
The inequality that we want can be arrived at, the inequality that we're looking for can be arrived at in a matter of seconds. very simple, is $25 is $25 per mile. So if you write m miles, that's the cost of m miles plus the $275 that you have to pay to begin with. And that quantity has to be less than or equal to $20. It's very simple. To arrive at that inequality should take no more than a few seconds. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.